subscribe and press this bell icon to never miss another lecture video. Hi, welcome to GEL, GATE ESE Lecture. We are in lecture number 18. This is your discrete time signal. Now we are heading into the mathematical operation of discrete time signal. So very interesting. It's exactly same as that of continuous time signal, exactly the same principle. Only what are the mathematical operations involved? Folding or time reversal, scaling, right? Shifting, addition, multiplication, integration, differential. We are not getting into a detailed thing of like addition, multiplication, integration, differentiation. We'll only stick to those points which are extremely important for mostly GATE exams, because GATE ke exam ke liye bahut important hai. Discrete time signals ka involvement in mathematical operation of mathematical operation. Now let's start with the folding thing, folding or time reversal, transpose or reflection. As we can see, same thing. You need to take a mirror image along x equals to 0, that is on a y axis, and if you take the folding, it will get folded like this. The way these three samples adhere in this right side, that they will get down in this way. So you understand it, this there is the same principle. Aapko bas khali waise karna hai. There is no like isko maine agar isko, for example, if I take like this, look here, for example, I have something like this, and it's a mirror image, will be the mirror image of this will be this. No, first the smaller one will come, then the bigger one will come. This will be your x of minus n if this is x of n, or if this is x of minus n, this will be x of n. So you understand it, it's a very simple thing. It's the same way that we have studied in continuous time signal. Similarly for time shifting, it obeys the same principle. The way for example, if we have a continuous time signal like this and it is at position A, if I want to shift it to if it is a position at a zero, if it position at a zero, if I want to shift it to A, if I want to shift it to A, so this will be x of t minus A. If this is x of t, then this will be x of t minus A. That means this x of t is get delayed to A amount. X of t is get delayed to A amount. The same way that the discrete time signals obeys the same principle. If we have this impulse functions like this at this zero point, so del of n minus m, that means it get delayed to m amount, delayed to this m amount. Or we can make another like sketch for advance. Let me do it. This is for advance. Okay, look here, this is for example, this is p. okay, this is the p position. So this graph will be del of n plus p, I'm sorry, negative, minus p. okay, so this will be del of n plus p. So this is advanced, jaldi aa gaya, advanced unit impulse. I'm sorry, unit impulse, sare ke sare unit impulse hai. okay, now let's move on. Moving on, addition of two discrete time signals, a very simple thing. Look here, this is one discretized signal which is started from A, B, whose magnitude is A at 0th position, because it is your origin, arrow mark is here, 0, 1, 2, minus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 1, 0 and 1. So x1n, x2n, and if you want to add these two term, you need to put it on under the same way, like for the same sample. So basically addition and multiplication, both are done on sample by sample basis. So you need to make it in the same zone, like in the same zone, in the same position, so that the addition will be simpler. So you make a zero padding in this way and you can add them right now. Now x1n of x2n will be 0 plus e at minus 1th position, and this is 0th position, this is 1th position and 2th position. So iske hisab se aap minus 1, 0, 1 and 2. So you can do this. clear hai, there is no like rocket science here. It's a very simple concept. Multiplication is done in the same method, in the same sample by sample method. Instead of plus, you can do the multiplication here. Okay, now the most important part, time scaling. So basically time scaling of discrete time signal is very important for gate point of view. This terminology is very important. Basically discrete time signal is actually done time scaling in this two-way decimation and interpolation. Bahut easy hai. Listen to this carefully. Time scaling means what? Your time domain, discrete time domain is gate replaced with A into N. So that is, this is your scaling factor. Now, if your scaling factor is greater than 1, then the process is called as decimation. If your scaling factor is less than 1, then that will be regarded as your interpolation. Okay, less than 1 means it lies between 0 to 1. So that will be regarded as your interpolation. Remember, always remember these two terminals. So let's do a decimation example. So the final sample will be less than that the original one. So basically, the decimation is like compressed the signal. Okay, interpolation is actually expand your signal. So the final sample will be, will be more than that of original signal. Okay, interpolation is more than that of original signal, and decimation is less than, make it less than that of original signal. Now if my original signal is this 4 7 3, so this is your minus 2 ka position, this is 1 ka position, ye 0 ka position, ye 1 ka position, ye 2 ka position hai. So at these respective position, these are the magnitude value of that discrete time signal f of n. Now I'm going to do decimation. Why? Because I'm going to, instead of n, I'm going to replace it by 2n, f of 2n. So f of 2n will be, look here carefully, what I'm going to do, look here, 4 3 9, clear hai? Now in the similar way, for interpolation, we need to add number of zeros. Sir, kitna zeros add karna hai aur kahan pe add karna hai aur kyun karna hai sir? Because you need to expand it. Interpolation is the method of expansion. That means if you are scaling by 1 by 2, that is your, if you're scaling this by the scaling factor which is lies between 0 to 1, that means you need to, so for how many zeros that you need to add, remember this formula, A equals A minus how many zeros? This is A minus a number of zeros. Clear hai? So kitna number add karna hai, that will define from A minus 1. So yahan pe A kitna hai sir? 2 hai sir. A is 2 hai sir. So A is, what is that scaling factor is exactly? Okay, you just need to take that denominator value. Understand it. So from here, if you take here, if you consider A is actually the, it will be in this format, f of 1 by A into n. Okay, from here you need to find out the value of A. Clear hai? It's a very simple concept. So this A value, from this A value you need to find out the number of zeros. So what is the value of A here? Sir, 2 hai sir. So that means 2 minus 1, that means 0, zeros will be 1. Number of zeros will be 2 minus 1, that is 1. So, ek ek zero hum add karenge. Kaise karenge? Look here. 4, 0, 7, 0, 3, 0, 5, 0, 9. Clear hai? And we have the same position for our origin. Clear hai? This is the very simple method through which that you are going to have like detail analysis. So basically this two terminology is important, decimation and interpolation. Please go through these notes again. These notes will down in the description. Write it down in your note, whatever things that you have understood on your language. Okay, don't expect that we should provide you any PDF file. Okay, please follow this lecture note. Now let's get into a very simple question. So it is saying ki there is this function which is defined is equals to 0 for n lies between minus 4 to 3, and it is 2 for other values. It is 2 for other values. That means it is saying, I read it wrongly. X of n is 0, like minus 4, so like for example, look here. It is saying this is your minus 4, this is how your 3 is. It is saying x of n is 0 for all these values. X of n is 0 for all these values. Or except this interval, ye sare interval mein iska value 2 hai. You got this point? Iska value 2 hai. Kitne interval honga? Minus 4 matlab minus 3 hoga, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2. To ye sab ke jagah pe iska value 2 hai. Clear hai ye concept? Now, what you need to do, you need to find out f of minus n plus 3. This is your f of n. Ye sare 0 hai, ye sare 0 hai. Now, you need to find out f of minus n plus 3. Now, we know how to reach f of minus n plus 3 jane ke liye. Sir, pehle sir, shifting karenge, sir. Haan. फिर उसके बाद हम लोग रिवर्सल करेंगे सर हां एब्सोल्युटली करें अंडरस्टैंड इट नाउ यू नीड टू राइट इट डाउन द फर्स्ट f ऑफ n सो वी हैव टेकन x ऑफ n ओके सो यू नीड टू राइट डाउन x ऑफ n एंड x ऑफ n लुक्स लाइक दिस इट इज 0 फॉर ऑल द वैल्यूज 0 फॉर ऑल द वैल्यूज इट इज ओनली डिफाइंड बिटवीन माइनस 4 से लेके लुक योर -4 से लेके -3 तक तो ये पोजीशन में दिस इज योर जीरोथ पोजीशन 1 2 3 सो एक्सेप्ट दिस पोजीशन अदर वैल्यूज आर 0 नाउ यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट x ऑफ n plus 3 n plus 3 का मतलब दिस वैल्यू दैट मींस ओरिजिन विल शिफ्ट लेफ्ट साइड दैट मींस इट विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस हियर यू अंडरस्टैंड नो लुक हियर केयरफुली इट इज सेइंग this is my graph look here -1 -2 -3 1 2 3 -4 now I need to do it this is your graph you need to do n plus 3 matlab ye idhar aa jayega that means you'll get your value 2 so, kitne 2s hai 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 2 2 2 2 2 your origin will be here so ye jo hai ye sab idhar aa jayega so aapka kitna kaisa ho jayega look here carefully aisa ho jayega 2 3 4 5 got this idea you got like this kind of graph so you this is converted to x of n plus 3 now I need to replace n माइनस एन इन प्लेस ऑफ एन सो ये इसका रिवर्सल हो जाएगा तो ऐसा हो जाएगा ग्राफ है कि नहीं ऐसा हो जाएगा एक्स ऑफ माइनस एन प्लस थ्री क्लियर है इस तरह ग्राफ हो जाएगा सो वील गेट अ ग्राफ लाइक 2 2 2 2 2 2 2 एंड you're going to get a graph like this. So it is saying what are the values of n for which f of minus n plus 3 is guaranteed to be 0. What are the values for n? So ye position kya hai? Ye position hai 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What are the values of n? So n belongs to 0 to 6. It is giving non-zero values except r difference 0 to 6 you can say like this okay now except any kind of like number like integer we are considering integer no I minus 0 to 6 so whatever the value except this 0 to 6 that give you guarantee 0 clear hai ye concept is a very simple question I want you to try it out by yourself it's a very simple question if you have understood it just skip to the next video lecture in the next video lecture we'll get into the classification of discrete time signals thank you so much for watching this video see you in the next video lecture till then bye